Let me ask you this. Want to learn how to soar through the air and hit those high shots? Welcome back, guys, to another Rocket League video. I'm so excited, man. I'm your motivation guy, Keith Allen, and today we're going to be going over how to accurately perform aerials in your games. So hit that like button and let's get this going. So the aerial is a mechanic used for almost everything in Rocket League. Aerials are fundamental for the game. It's the first step that you can take to change your gameplay to the next level. The difference between a well-planned out aerial shot and one you get just by trying to hit the ball in the air is astronomical. A well-planned aerial can be one of the strongest attacks in the game. It allows you to crush your opponents with insane pressure, or even help you get out of that pressure with the game-changing clear. Aerials are constructed from a few things: setting your car up, the contact with the ball, then recovery. So the first thing that you want to know about aerials are how to go for them. You can't just go for an aerial without some sort of plan. You have to know where you want your car headed in the air. So the setup for the aerial will let you achieve that. This is a very important step because if you don't set your car up correctly, it can result in you whiffing or getting a bad touch. What do I mean by setting up your car? Setting up your car is everything that you do up until your car is in the air headed towards the ball. The amount of boost you have, the placement of your car, and the path of the ball. And so we're going to go over these one by one. The amount of boost that you have is insanely important. It will dictate how high and fast of a hit that you can get on the ball. You can technically hit any ball in the air with as little as 12 boosts, but a good number to have to get a hit on the ball would be 40 boosts. Anything past this will allow you to get more and more decisive hits. We know a ton of people who love grabbing the 100 boosts before going for any aerial or just having anything above 80, but don't be shy to go for one if you have less. Boost is not an insane priority if you have enough for a hit. Now, understanding the path of the ball is also very important, and this is going to let you know how much boost you will generally need and will help you decide on where to hit the ball. So try and think of the ball going in a line, and you are trying to place your car on that line to intersect with the ball. Okay, so watch here. When you aerial for the ball, it isn't directly towards the ball. Instead, you know, you're just aerialing towards a point that your car will intersect with the ball. It will take some practice to get used to really understanding the speed that the ball is going and, you know, how to pick a spot to aim your car at. And so understanding this will come from just simply practicing. You know, I know a lot of newer people just aim for the ball rather than doing this, which makes aerials seem nearly impossible. This is a very important step because the faster you see the path of the ball, the sooner you can go for the aerial and beat or surprise your opponents. So now that we covered those two, you can then cover how to place your car on the field for the aerial. The way you want to place your car is to try and get to the ball the fastest while also being able to recover afterwards. You can place your car anywhere on the field, really, even on the wall if needed. Watch again here where you're positioning your car. The ball is coming towards your net, and instead of just jumping up to go for it, you rotate backwards so you have more room for the aerial and your nose is pointed towards the car. You begin to drive forward towards where you want to bring your car into the air to intersect with the ball, giving you a forward momentum. And so then you jump up and aerial to the spot that you picked out. Then after the touch, you have a clear area of where to land your car and have enough boost to rotate back into position. You want your car placed on a part of the field that will cleanly intersect the ball with the amount of boost you have. It's a lot simpler said than done, definitely admit that. So a good way to get good at that, you guessed it, is to practice. Likewise, you know, free play is a great place to practice anything in Rocket League, but there are some training packs as well that will help with this. And so my first recommendation is to go into free play and understand how much boost it takes to keep your car in the air. So a good way to practice this is by feathering your boost. Feathering your boost is when you tap the boost just enough to give your car the height it needs by using the minimal amount of boost. To practice feathering, go to anywhere on the field, then jump and tilt your car upwards like so. Hold your boost down to get your car in the air, then practice just feathering it in the same position. After you get that down, time to practice the movements your car makes while in the air. Starting from one side of the field, aim for the net at the other side and just try to keep your car at the same height without touching the ground. After you get used to this, start trying to aim for a corner or a specific spot on the net to get some control over it. Now, this is very beginner level stuff. If you want to ramp it up, there are some training packs listed on the screen to try and practice. The top of the list is easier and they rank harder going down. All right, so now that we have setting up your car down, we can go over making contact with the ball. Once you hit the ball, you're going to want to make sure you're hitting it the way you want. So to start off, we should go over what parts of the car hits the hardest. The nose of the car always hits the hardest when done correctly. Then the roof of your car, sides, rear, and then the wheels. You never want to hit the ball while performing a simple aerial with the wheels of your car. This creates zero power and even sometimes will bounce your car off of the ball. Hitting it with the sides and rear of your car are perfectly fine if hitting a rough angle, but if you can avoid it, definitely do so. There is really no reason to slow the ball down. Now the roof of your car hits pretty solid and it's a large surface, so we see a lot of people tilting their car before hitting it to avoid touching with their wheels or getting a bad hit. And that's perfectly fine, but we don't recommend it because then it takes longer to get out of that habit and start hitting it with the more powerful part of your car, the nose. All right, so now you understand what each part of the car generates when hitting the ball. Making contact is as simple as really thinking of where you want it to go. Typically, you can flip into the car to decide where it goes, but for an aerial, you want to use that second jump instead of a flip to get higher in the air. So now that you can't use a flip, how are you going to decide where it goes? It's simple. Just hit the ball on the opposite side of where you want it to go. Hitting it from the left makes it go right, and hitting it from the right makes it go left. It's a little hard to get insanely precise with some of the hits, but if you hit it in a general area you want it to go, chances are your teammates can finish. Now, generating power behind the hit is also another technique. Remember back to, you know, when we talked about feathering your boost? You want to really only feather your boost when going for a power hit once your car hits supersonic. Supersonic is the maximum speed your car can go. You want to be supersonic when going for a power shot as well as aim for the opposite side the ball is headed. And so you can generate some insane power behind a shot if you hit it correctly. So always try and aim with your nose and just be at supersonic speed. Recovery is another very important part of the aerial. You know, the aftermath of you hitting the ball is detrimental to what happens next. And just like before when setting up for the aerial, you need to always set yourself up for a quick recovery after. If you watch here, after you hit the ball, you look at your surroundings before using any boost. And so you see that there is a spot for you to really land on the wall, so you tilt your car to land on the wall and use the rest of your boost to rotate back. This is important because if you fly too high and hit the ball with your boost, you're going to be left hanging in the air while the opposing team can build up an attack and score. So when going for an aerial, always make sure that you have a route plan for a swift and efficient recovery to get back into position and keep striking. So a good way to do this is to always have your car placed upright after the hit. And so guys, remember to refrain from using all your boosts. It's good to have some left over to get yourself to the ground and grab some more to get yourself back into a defensive rotation. Also, try and aim your car towards the direction you want to start driving once you land. This can be a little tricky, so learning how to half flip or wave dash is another great trick to learn. If you don't know what those are, don't worry about it. We're going to cover those mechanics in a future video. Now, recovery might seem simple, but it's the simplest thing that you can mess up. You know, the aerial is a simple but deadly trick that is really easy to learn once you break it down into these three steps. And I really hope this video helped you guys really understand and practice this trick. And you know, I really wanted you to leave your comments. And if you guys want another trick that you want me to go over in the next video, let me know. Hey, if you guys like the video, subscribe to the channel. And if you want some more motivation, you know, I'm here, man, your motivation guy. Follow me. I'm here to connect with you. And I'll see you on the next one. Peace. We'll be right back.